Hi, and welcome to the first Staples High School ITL screencast on Blackboard. So today we're going to talk about the calendar of classes function that's available to us within that Blackboard. What the calendar of classes will allow us to do is to give the students one centralized location to find all of the important materials that they will need for all of their classes. So instead of going into each individual class, they can just go into the calendar, and if teachers populate the calendar with information for their classes, the students will be able to get that all in one location. So let's find out how this works. Go into one of my classes. And the first thing that you're going to notice is with my buttons on the side, I do not have a button in this class for my class calendar. Right, so the first thing I'll do is set up a button. And to do that, I start in the control panel right here. So what I want to do is add the actual class calendar tool onto my button display. So I come to Manage Class Tools. And this is where you're going to find all the buttons that I have available. And I want to add a button for my calendar, and a calendar in Blackboard is considered a tool. So I click on the tool button. And then I want to choose the type of tool that I'm going to add, and in this case it's going to be the calendar. And then I have to add the calendar, the name for the calendar, so I'll call it, there we go, calendar. Make sure the check mark is ticked so that the students can actually see the calendar. I click submit, okay, and if I go back to my class, I'll see that the calendar button is now available. Now, in order to populate the calendar, you cannot populate the calendar from the button. You have to actually go into the control panel, click on the class calendar, right, and if I view the month, I can see all the stuff that I have in my calendar already. And if I want to add an event, I simply go to Add Event. And now I get to add the information that I want to add. So I want to remind my students that there's a homework assignment and that they have to read some of the book and answer some of the questions. Now, this window allows you to do some basic text editing, bold, italics, underlined, center, left center, right center, all those kinds of things, highlight, change the color of the text, etc. You can also add flash animations. You can add audio if you want to actually describe what the homework is. You can add QuickTime movies, MPEG movies, videos, text links. All these things are available to you in the calendar. You can also add links to worksheets, anything that you want the students to actually read. So that button is right here. It's the piece of paper with the paperclip on it. So if I click on that, I will get the content link window. Now, the rub here is that you have to enter your content from the content collection. You can't enter it from the Y drive or your desktop or Snap drive. You have to enter it from the content collection. So I've put stuff in the content collection, and since I've done that, let's see, this is period 5, I want to attach this document. This Word document that I have set up. So all I do is I click on the button to say that that's the one that I want to choose, and then click submit, and it shows up there. Again, it's in the content collection, browse, it's under my courses, period 5, and then I chose this particular document that I wanted to add to it. Alright, so that document is connected, submit, and it becomes a linked document here. Choose a date, so I want this to be due, next week sometime, October 20th. The time, just make sure that the start time and the stop time aren't the same, so it won't allow you to enter it. If it is, then I click submit. and I've added that homework assignment on the 20th. So when a student clicks on that homework assignment, this is what they're going to get. If they click on the link that I attached to it, it'll load that up, and I can actually now open it up as a Word document. Okay. So, I go back to my homepage. And if I want those assignments, my upcoming assignments, to actually appear under my classes, right, in this window, there is a pencil mark up here in the upper right-hand corner. If I click on the pencil mark up here in the upper right-hand corner, I get the customize page, and this allows me to customize the look of that my classes page. So for example, I didn't want to see class of 2011 every time I opened it up, so I turned that off and I don't have to view that anymore. So I want my period 5 calendar information to appear. So I click over here on the right and I can display those calendar events. Click submit. Now my upcoming calendar events appear under my classes. Okay, and then the one that I created for the 20th, again, comes up right here. Now when a student clicks on their calendar of all classes, they will get all of their assignments from all of their teachers. If they want to isolate it, they can come up here and choose just which classes they want to appear one information, and it'll get rid of all the other information. So it actually allows them to choose which classes they want to see. And that's basically it. I know it seems like a lot of clicks, but it will give the students what they're looking for with that calendar feature to get all their stuff in one spot. If you have any questions, please email us at the ITL committee, and we'll be happy to help you out.